controversial transgender model Monroe Bergdorf was warned over her behavior after she repeatedly dropped the N-word and used offensive slurs on live TV. Monroe had been on Good Morning Britain being interviewed about Twitter's new rules cracking down on hateful conduct and abusive behavior, which led to the leader and deputy of far-right group Britain First having their accounts suspended. But while recounting the type of abuse she's had from trolls, Monroe kept saying the N-word, pulling her up on her previous online rant that led to her L'Oreal sacking. Piers Morgan asked, "Why should you be allowed to express an opinion that all white people are violent racists or have that potential? And yet Britain First, which said all Muslims are violent people, they're now banned. Because white people aren't oppressed. These groups are assembled to feed into a narrative of alt-right," she shot back. After Piers defended the right of freedom of speech, Monroe almost said the N-word again. "These people are abusing their freedom of speech. You can't just go around calling black women in the media." But Susanna stopped her, saying, "I just need to interrupt just because you've already used words you can't use at this time in the morning. I'm not going to say it. People continuously target black women in the media. This is a solution, shutting down these accounts," the model said. "I can't say NR, but I'm going to say it." Piers chipped in, "We would like you to stop just using the word. My opinion is that the more that people use it, any color, the worse it is." But Monroe defended her actions again, telling the panel, "This reaction of me using the N-word is seen as more violent than the fact that we are actually called this. Yet we are allowed to show blackface. It's highly racist." It came after Monroe brought Cheryl Cole into her fight with L'Oreal after the cosmetics giant sacked her for comments about white people's racial violence. Monroe had appeared on the Victoria Derbyshire show to point out that she'd been sacked, while Cheryl, who was convicted of punching a black toilet attendant but acquitted of racially aggravated ABH back in 2003, was still employed by the cosmetics giant. "This has been world news, and it's not something that should be world news," she told Victoria of her being dropped by L'Oreal. "I shouldn't be sacked for calling out racism when I was in a campaign that was meant to be championing diversity. And especially when I was speaking about the violence of white people," she went on. "But then they've got Cheryl Cole on the campaign, and she was convicted for actively punching a black woman in the face. I don't understand how I'm not in line with their values, but they will hire Cheryl Cole over and over again and give her more and more chances, but she was convicted for punching a black woman in the face. Does she not deserve a second chance?" Victoria asked her. "I think if you're going to put a woman who punched a black woman in the face and the face of diversity, that just says a lot about white privilege, which proves my point," Monroe added. Cheryl then put out a statement through her rep pointing out how disappointed she was to be dragged into the L'Oreal incident. More than 14 years ago, Cheryl was unanimously acquitted of a charge of racially aggravated assault, said the statement. She is disappointed to find her name involved in Monroe Bergdorf's media interview. Around the same time, Piers had his first run-in with Monroe on Good Morning Britain. An angry Piers questioned the model over comments she'd made on Facebook about white privilege, and insisted, "I'm not sexist, I'm not racist, and I'm not a homophobe. With the greatest respect, who are you to say all straight white guys are racist?" Bergdorf replied, "This is where there's a problem, as you're taking it personally. Instead of taking it personally, think how you can be part of the solution." Piers pointed out that the five of the most powerful on the planet are female, then asked if women could be misogynistic. The model responded, "I don't think a woman can enforce misogyny. Women don't uphold the patriarchy, Piers. Piers, you are part of the problem because you are denying my lived experience. You're speaking over me for one," she added. L'Oreal revealed its decision to terminate her contract in a tweet, stating that as champions of diversity it felt the model's comments were at odds with those of the company, and that it could no longer work with her. L'Oreal champions diversity. Comments by Monroe Bergdorf are at odds with our values, and so we have decided to end our partnership with her, the statement read. According to the Daily Mail, Monroe wrote on Facebook, "Honestly, I don't have energy to talk about the racial violence of white people anymore. Yes, all white people. Because most of y'all don't even realize or refuse to acknowledge that your existence, privilege and success as a race is built on the backs, blood and death of people of color. Your entire existence is drenched in racism. From microaggressions to terrorism, you guys built the blueprint for this ST." She continued, "Come see me when you realize that racism isn't learned, it's inherited and consciously or unconsciously passed down through privilege. Once white people begin to admit that their race is the most violent and oppressive force of nature on earth, then we can talk. Until then, stay acting shocked about how the world continues to stay FD at the hands of your ancestors and your heads that remain buried in the sand with hands over your ears." A company insider told the Mail, "L'Oreal do not in any way condone or agree with Monroe's comments. Obviously, this is all highly embarrassing and very much goes against message. To drop her now would be something of a PR disaster, but, at the same time, they cannot be seen to be endorsing any kind of racism or extremism. Conversations about her future are taking place." But critics pounced on the company's stance and accused it of denying Monroe a voice. "How can you claim to champion diversity and then fire her for speaking out against systemic racism?" asked one. "Honestly, I can't stop thinking about how you have said that pointing out that white supremacy is bad is at odds with our values." Another told the brand, "I'm honestly disgusted. You've pulled her contract because she dared to comment that racism exists. How was anything she said wrong or at odds with championing diversity? You're pandering to white people who don't want to hear the truth, and I am so disgusted." Monroe herself responded to the firing on Facebook, writing a long post about how her original comments about the recent violence committed by white supremacists in Charlottesville were taken out of context. "Whether aware of it or not, in today's society, the lighter your skin tone, people of color included, the more social privileges you will be afforded," she wrote. "A person's race and skin tone has a huge part to play in how they are treated by society as a whole, based on their proximity to whiteness." Addressing claims in the press that she'd branded all white people racist, Monroe continued, "I was addressing that fact that Western society as a whole is a system rooted in white supremacy, designed to benefit, prioritize and protect white people before anyone of any other race. Unknowingly, white people are socialized to be racist from birth onwards. It is not something genetic. No one is born racist." The British model went on to highlight how all discrimination, including sexism, racism and homophobia, cannot be eradicated until the source of inequality is tackled. She finished with a scorching riposte to L'Oreal, adding, "So when a transgender woman of color, who has been selected to front up a big brand campaign to combat discrimination and lack of diversity in the beauty industry, speaks on her actual lived experience of being discriminated against because of her race and identifies the root of where that discrimination lies, white supremacy and systemic racism, that big brand cannot simply state that her thoughts are not in line with the ethics of the brand." Her followers applauded Monroe's speech, calling her dignified and informative. Monroe, who is also a DJ and fashion designer, has appeared alongside the likes of Cheryl Cole, Neelam Gill and Katie Piper as part of her L'Oreal work.